Good morning, and welcome back to the Survivor Series with Doc Stout. Once again, we're playing Don't Starve with Wolfgang. We're on the seventh day. Found a permanent camp spot nearby a couple of beefalo. Have a little bit of food. I don't know if I've got enough to keep his mighty belly sated. And we have a cool feather hat. I'm going to have to immediately head out. My food is going to hold for the day, probably. But I desperately need to find gold. I have to run through this area. That's awkward. You can't actually run through ponds. Which means that thing's going to take a swing at me. Eh! Alright. So I'm back on the quest for gold. I had two directions I could have chosen. I have elected to go this way. Mostly because of these roads. Yeah, if I follow the road, it should make me just enough faster that maybe I'll be able to find gold and get back to camp before nightfall. Worst comes to worst, I will have to just make a temporary fire for the night. I'm not even sure it's possible to get gold off of a rock that looks like this, but I need to try and hit every rock that I see. Yeah, I played the bulk of my many hours in this game in an old build. Where the heck am I going? Oh, this is a different direction. This is not actually where I initially intended to go, but this isn't too bad. Got a lot more berries. That's not going to tax my inventory. I've already got some. We'll skip the local carrots. Because I intend to have that inventory spot for gold. Alright. Gotta explore the map. I think what I'm looking for is the sort of rocky territory where the tall birds are found. And as well as the types of rocks that I have found typically contain gold. Mapping out this area, though, it's not looking good. Sanity appears to be mostly intact. We're on day 7, so we got a little bit of time before winter, but I am starting to get just a little bit nervous. Alright, I guess I gotta find the road again and go the other way. Let's see here. Alright, here we go. Here's the road. Soon I'll have to stop for a little bit of food. I'm far from mighty. Alright. That should do for the moment. Replace my berry supply as I walk. Looks like it's going to be another night of roast berries. Because we do not have the technology for anything yummier. Aim to fix that. Okay, we've got some graves. Pig huts. It looks like the pigs and the spiders have been at war lately. We're just gonna let them sort out their differences. I should stick around to see if any of the pigs are gonna die and if I can get their meat. But it looks like they're gonna win. Good for them. Man, I am already running out of time on the seventh day. Not a moment suggesting that I'm even heading towards gold. I may have to do the desperate thing, which I do not like to do, which is to grab a torch and wander out at night. Another beefalo herd. This would not be a terrible spot for if I needed to move camp. After all, I haven't established anything at my current campsite aside from a permanent fire pit. Man. Oh yeah, we're gonna wake up a spider. I cannot believe I did not wake up a spider there. Man. Hello, tree. Yep, no way I'm making it back tonight. And we saw far too many spider nests for me to get too much more exploration in. Alright. Gonna have to make a temporary fire tonight. I do not care for that. Got enough logs. It's been bad luck so far on the exploration. If you're joining me on Twitch, once again, I find myself a little bit behind and don't have the second screen set up to interact with chat, so thank you for watching, even if I don't interact as much as I have in other series that I've recorded. I'm gonna make a brand new axe. This would be a terrible time to anger the trees. Guess we'll roast some of those seeds. Burn the flowers. Oh yeah, I can hear that I'm still a little closer than I'd maybe like to spiders. I don't know how far the spiders range out from their nests when it gets completely dark. Suppose we're about to find out. Quickly pick stuff up. No more chopping for tonight. Alright. One more long night out in the woods. I suppose I'm gonna have to check up this way next. Try and map that area out. This may be the longest I have ever gone without finding gold. I don't know if they intentionally made it more difficult to find to make the early game more challenging. If that was their intention, it's working. Because it's going to be much harder for me to prepare for winter while I'm trying to do things that in the early patches, the pre-winter patches, would have been like my day 2 and day 3 activities. And still hope to survive. So let's eat a couple more roasted berries. My sanity's still doing okay, but my stomach needs a little bit of attention. Alright, as soon as it gets light, day 8, I'm gonna just book it to the north. Seems like a Survivor series so far has been the never-ending quest for gold. I'd like to start to get into crafting, but I think I've crafted everything I know how to make. With the exception of a nice grass vest. And I've been avoiding conflict, so I don't think that's necessarily anything that's all that important to me. Alright, so this is where we are. Is this a fresh road? Yes, this is a fresh road. Maybe this can take us to somewhere useful. I am not a fan of swamps. Alright, I'm gonna try and move as fast as I can through the swamp. Okay. Try not to take any tentacle damage. Okay, here we go. There's a road through the swamp. That's good. Are we going to park all of our sources of gold on the other side of the biggest swamp I have ever seen in this game? Wow. Does it ever end? Yeah. Oh boy. Gotta not get caught up on ponds or anything. I have never seen a swamp this massive before. I certainly don't want to be caught out here when it gets darker. My god, this map is nightmarish. Swamps for days. Yikes. At least I'm doing better than I usually do in avoiding the tentacles. Either I'm getting lucky, or they made them a little easier to avoid so long as you keep moving. Wow. It just goes on and on and on. So far, only ending, like, at the shoreline. I'm not even gonna be able to stop and find food. World's most massive swamp. Alright, well, that was terrible. So, at least we're back in the woods. I may have to abandon any thoughts of finding gold today and just look for food for the night. What's that? That's an evil flower. Of course it did. Oh, more swamp. How about that? So I was just thinking, you know, I need more swamp. And the little rocky area that I've been looking for this entire time? Yeah, we found some. What is that? Oh, God. Okay, that's a killer bee nest. Holy... Oh, goodness. Okay, I think I've chosen the wrong way to go. Wow. I have never seen so many bees. Okay. Well, this is kind of what we were looking for. Gold. Success. All right, we're a little hurt. There's approximately 7 million bees between us and the way home. Yes, the scary time is coming soon. Wow. Alright, I guess I'll get a little bit more gold. He's hard, like me. And the crazy thing is finding all those bees means that I'm pretty far from Maxwell's door. Not yet. Okay, that's cool. So we found a doorway to adventure mode. That's neat. I'm almost completely out of food, though. I think I'm going to have to spend the morning... Let's make some fire here. And I'm going to be forced to eat those seeds just to live through the night. Make another pickaxe real quick. I'm going to get as much gold as I can because I am never coming back here. I was just on the verge of complaining about how the first few episodes of the series have been incredibly similar. I was starting to get a little boring. Whew! Well, we found some excitement today. And I guess the next day, which will be the next episode, we're going to actually get to some science. Assuming I can make it through B Central Station. Alright, I have no food. Let's grab these seeds before it's too dark to reach them. I have 27 rocks. I am not doing so hot on food, and it's going to get worse before it gets better. My breezy vest is at 10%. Does it stop decaying if I don't wear it? I don't know. Maybe I've been wearing and wasting a winter coat this entire time. Not used to finding them before winter. Alright, but here, lonely with my feather hat and 4 gold nuggets, I reach the end of day 8, so if I can survive the terrible, terrible trip back to base camp, I should be able to do some science and start to prepare for the long winter ahead. But this is going to be the end of day 8, beginning of day 9. Which, as always, is where I call the episodes, 2 days apiece. I'd like to thank you for watching so far. Definitely been a more exciting episode than usual. And we've got some great things ahead. So, this is Doc Stout with the Survival Series playing Don't Starve. And I am signing out.